It's something that, I gotta tell you guys, this is just something I've learned over many, many years. Something you may not agree with, but wow, I really think this is true. And then we're talking to the CEO again. There's a partnership in every company which, if it can be made and made well, can have huge impact on the business results of the company. And here's the business partnership. Great marketing and great technology. But the marketing side of the business is cooperating intensively with the IT, with BT side of the business. And I gotta tell you, in most companies, this is a bitch. I mean, really, it just is. The marketing guys hate the, it's breeding cats and dogs, it is an unnatural act, but where I've seen it work, it's just been phenomenal. It has really, really paid off. Now, why do I say this? It's kind of simple, because look at the website, right? The website, if you give the website to IT, or BT, they invariably screw up the customer. If you give the website to marketing, they will invariably screw up the technology. I've watched that over and over and over again. So, Mr. CEO or Ms. CEO, you've got to push these two groups together. Somehow, some way, they've got to connect and talk the same language. So I see a lot of skepticism in the audience, but you know, I just got to tell you, I've seen it work over and over again. To make this happen, it's a supercharge. Now, so often the CEO will say, yeah, that's a good idea, but you know, it's difficult, et cetera. You know, and I don't really think that matters. What is the connection between marketing and technology? What does it mean? So I'll do this. I'll say, you know what this is? Do you know what this is?
Postage stamp.
Postage stamp.
Postage stamp.
Postage stamp. That's close. Barcode. It's a barcode. Yeah. This is actually a very. It's probably the most advanced barcode in the world. It's something called the QR code, the quick response code, invented in Toyota. And I think I've got this right. That's 2K bits on that you're looking at. It's a lot of data on a printed artifact. It's called the QR code. Now why am I showing this to the CEO? Well, if you go to Japan, you will see this everywhere. And the true story, if you go to McDonald's in Tokyo, buy a Big Mac, and take that, you know, eat the Big Mac, take that greasy wrapper and flip it over. On the other side, you're going to find a QR code. Now why? Because if you, cell phone, the 95% of the cell phones in Japan, this is actually not true of my BlackBerry, have a macro lens. So you take your cell phone, you point it at that QR code, and you click. The cell phones can recognize the code and link you immediately to the site of McDonald's. So what you're doing here is when you click on the QR code on that greasy wrapper, you get all the ingredients of the Big Mac immediately on your cell phone. But you see it everywhere in Japan. You're going to see this thing in the U.S. actually pretty quickly. You know, what's going to happen? If you look at the New York Times 3 years from now, you'll be reading an article in the paper, New York Times, you know, if that's still around. If you read that, and at the bottom of the article, you're going to see the QR code. You're going to take your cell phone and click, and then you're going to see all the other stuff they have online, how to do that article on your cell phone. It's going to link to you. This is the way you're walking to a billboard as they did for a movie. Click on it, find out where every movie theater is at in Manhattan. It's going to be everywhere, and this, you can only do this if you have marketing and IT cooperating to make this all go. I know that's a painful thought. I know it will be quite difficult, but I'm speaking from long-term experience. If you can make this work, that will have a great benefit for you.